Let's welcome in our guest joining us on the show as well. On the fundamentals, we have Mr. K. Subramaniam of Altamount Capital, and on the technicals, Richard Jain of Angel Broking joining in. Thanks so much for joining in. Richard, let me start with you. You know, we did close out the August series on a slightly muted note, similarly closed out the week as well below that 11,700 mark. But for the week, fresh life highs coming in once again at the index level. What is the range that you are looking at going into next week?
Yeah, very good afternoon. Certainly, although we have seen a very range-bound trading in last couple of trading sessions, but if we broadly see, then the broader trend for the markets is still positive. The high top, high bottom structure is still continuing, and these last 3-4 trading sessions, which have been more of a sideways, this just seemed to be a time-wise correction within an uptrend. So if we see the historical data, then in mid-July we had seen a breakout from a consolidation phase in the markets, and post that we have continuously seen a trended up move. Now whatever corrections have been seen in last 2.5-3 months, all those corrections have been a time correction in the sense that whenever the momentum readings get overbought, prices stay sideways for a few trading sessions, and again the market then resumes its uptrend. So we believe that last 3-4 trading sessions of this range bound activity is just a time wise correction within an uptrend. In next week we should again resume the broader degree uptrend. So 11,600 is a very strong support for the market. So keeping a base as 11,600, one should definitely look to create fresh long positions, and on the higher side we are expecting levels around 11,800 followed by 11,940.
In fact, Richard, a bit of the pressure coming in was clearly from a Reliance. It's a heavyweight. When it was making record life highs, so was the Nifty. And of course, when we saw a bit of a cool off set into this one, we've seen the Nifty to take a bit of a breather. What is the sense that you get looking at the chart of Reliance at this point?
So one should not forget that in this entire uptrend in last 3-4 months, Reliance has been one of the outperformers, and within the large cap space, this stock has taken the leadership. Now, just a minor correction of 3-4 trading sessions does not change the trend of the stock. So the broader trend for the stock still remains positive. In fact, we think that this corrective action which has been going on in Reliance Industries would again provide a buying opportunity to traders at lower levels. The stock has very strong support in the range of 1200 to 1220. So any minor declines further, if we see in Monday's trading session and the stock comes near in this range of 1200 to 1220, I think that would be a good opportunity to again create fresh long positions in Reliance Industries.
All right. So in action, the metals, for example, outperformed. But if you look at the entire month, the Pharma Nifty Index actually gained about 13-odd%. Very, very strong month coming in for this space. Talk about where you're looking as far as pharma goes. Of course, some of the mid-cap names have been outperforming, especially if we compare it to some of these frontline counters that have come under pressure. Specific names that are on your radar?
Definitely, if we see the Nifty Pharma Index, since the month of May 2018, this index bottomed around 8,100 range. Post that, continuously high up, high bottom structure has been there, and still even in today's trading session, we saw a gap up opening which was followed by a good momentum throughout the session. So I think this momentum is likely to continue, and as far as Nifty Pharma Index is concerned, we believe that in very short term, the stock would head higher further towards 10,740, 10,750 kind of range. Within the stock specific, the stocks that has been doing well or has been outperforming in last 3-4 months, they would continue to do so. Aurofarma looks positive even from current levels. The stock should show another 8-10% higher from current levels. And amongst other stocks, Biocon and Cadila are the two other names which on the charts are indicating a fresh breakout. Biocon has been witnessing a consolidation phase since last 1-1.5 months. And again, from its support zone, today we saw an up move which was supported by very good volume. So Biocon, one can look to enter at current levels. For short-term trading perspective, keeping a stop below 605, we are expecting levels around 655 to 660. And even Cadila Healthcare, although this has been one of the underperformer amongst the pharma names, but on the daily as well as the weekly chart, today's closing certainly is positive because the 200-day moving average resistance has been broken out. Then that also has been supported by very good volumes in last few days. So Cadila Healthcare is another name from the pharma space which could be bought at current levels. The stop should be below 375, and the target expected is in the range of 430 to 440.
All right, that's a Cadila Health along with an Aurobindo Pharma and Biocon. The stocks are on Richard's radar. In fact, Mr. Subramaniam, you know some of the few trading ideas. What's on your radar as you set yourself up for Monday morning?
Yeah, Yeah, we believe that there would be mid-cap names which would show outperformance during next week. So a couple of names from the mid-cap space, one would be BEML. Although some underperformance has been seen, but in today's trading session we had seen that in the morning the move was supported by very good volumes. A good open interest build-up was seen during the day also, which indicates fresh longs have been created. So one can go long on BEML at current levels, keeping stop below 810, expecting target around 900. And we also think that some of the PSU banking name pocket would now see a turnaround and good momentum could be seen. Oriental Bank of Commerce is one of the stock which has given a firm closing above its resistance, and last couple of days of move has also been supported by very good volumes. So OBC is a buy at current levels, keeping stock below 78 rupees. We expect target around 95 in next 1 to 2 weeks.
Alright, so that's a BEML as well as an Oriental Bank of Commerce. In fact, PSU banks really outperformed in the week gone by. We leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in, Mr. K. Subramaniam and Richard Jain joining in, really helping us understand what to keep in focus as you set yourself up for next week. But with that, we'll wrap it up here on this edition of